People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Most of you would have probably heard by now about the incident in Templar St. Andrew when three people get lit down. Right, now the names of those people has come out. Right, and as soon as I saw the name of one of the men, I immediately had to make a few phone calls because I know of this man. I don't know him personal to speak to, but I know of this man. The one I'm talking about is Philip George Ellis, otherwise known as Mega Plow. Now, if you go on Loop website, you will see it says Mega Plow was a 37-year-old resident of Brandon Hill District. And the other two men, Money Kelly, is from Spanish Town, and Donovan Guthrie is also from Spanish Town. Now, ask yourself the question, why would Spanish Town men be all the way up in Templar like a lit down? Let me make things a bit clearer for you. Mega Plow is also from Spanish Town. All three men come from Spanish Town. Right? Even though it says Mega Plow is a resident of the Brandon Hill District, Mega Plow is a longtime 87 Octane. He come from Spanish Town, but he actually ran away and went to Brandon Hill. Now, people who know Brandon Hill, as Vibes Cartel said, Brandon Hill have a lethal weapon. Brandon Hill has been known as a place where 87 Octanes and 90 Octanes can run away from town and reside. It's up there in St. Andrew, rural St. Andrew. Right? Some parts of Brandon Hill are very deep in the bush. As a matter of fact, if you really think about it, Brandon Hill is one way in and one way out. You have to go over this little bridge to get into Brandon Hill. And two cars can't pass on that bridge. Right. So it's very easy for people to spot when police are coming into the area. So it's a perfect place to run away. And Mega Plow actually run away from Spanish Town and go live at Brandon Hill. And he used to par with another old-time 90 Octane, and a man by the name of Tony Welch, who also ran away and did go over Brandon Hill. And he was over there for, I think he actually became some sort of done over there, right? But eventually police push him out. But what the Loop report should have said is Mega Plow, a former resident of Spanish Town. So now the picture is becoming clear. Why would three people from Spanish Town go all the way to the quiet community of Temple Hall and end up getting mashed up like this? People, you have to understand this. Mega Plow, as a Spanish Town man, when he's in Brandon Hill, it's very difficult for his enemies to get to him. Because, as I said, Brandon Hill is really one way in and one way out. Right? It's very difficult for you to go over there, do anybody something, and get out back. Right? That bridge is a choke point. Right, I don't know anybody listening to this who know Brandon Hill, but there's that bridge to enter Brandon Hill is a choke point. Right, cannot get in and get out so easy. But Temple Hall is kind of like a neutral turf. Temple Hall is actually a very nice, quiet area. This is why this shows you how you can live in some good area in Jamaica, some decent area, and 87 Octane still carry them foolishness, come mash up your community. Quite a lot of people have been getting taken out in Temple Hall because people see it as mutual territory, right? So when Brandon Hill, 87 Octanes, leave and go chill out in Temple Hall, that is where their rivals go catch them, right? So when you hear that Mega Plow drop out in Templar, don't be surprised, and there will be many more cases. Right? I don't know if you remember a couple years back, the same Tony Welch I'm talking about was implicated in another, I think it was also three or four people who did get lit down. Right? But that was over politics. Right? They were arguing over some government contracts over who should get it. Right? And there was a conflict between PNP and JLP members. Right, and for those who don't know, Tony Welch is aligned to the PNP, right? And there were some Labourites who were in contention for this government contract. And sake of that contract, they went to Templar again, right? And licked down about three people. Tony Welch and some other men were accused of that mission, right? I think they actually chased the men. People who are familiar with Templar know there's a river that runs alongside Templar, and some of the men, they actually ran from out of the MKR, run into the river, right? And Tony Welch and the shooters, them allegedly chased them and them straight down into the river and finished them off, right? That was one of the single biggest loss of life Templar has ever seen. But here we see another incident where three more people get hit. Where three more people drop out and them say six in total get hit. But you have to understand, when you see these things happening in places like Templar, Golden Spring, anywhere up that side, you have to understand these are outer town 87 Octanes. They're Spanish town people. They're town people, jungle people. People from West Kingston, right? People from outer East. Them go up that side for cool out, right? And their enemies go up there, go catch them, right? As I said, Mega Plow is a Spanish town man. The first thing, when you're reading the Loop article, the first thing that should have stood out to you is why was Templar all the way up there in rural St. Andrew? Why would two men from Spanish town end up all the way up there, so to the point where people are go up there to try and lick them down, right? But in the article, it says Mega Plow is a resident of Brandon Hill. That is true, he's a resident now, but Mega Plow is also from Spanish town, right? As I said, he's a runway, he is some acting. So look out for the following days and weeks after this incident, right? People, there will be retaliation, right? I'm just letting you know from now. Because based on who the money are linked with, they're not going to take this lying down, right? So the people of Templar, Golden Spring, that general region, just please be careful, right? Because as I said, even though that's a quiet area, quiet little neighborhood, these people are fighting an outer town war in the people in the neighborhood, right? So no wonder you be thinking, Templar, when things in place they get bad, it's not bad. As I said, Templar is a real nice area. These are outer town, man, right? So just watch the follow-up. What I'm going to do, right, I'm going to reach out to the, as I said, I know of Mega Plow, right? But I never used to speak to him, but I know people who did, right? So I'm going to actually reach out and link them people if you are one, right? Because this is not going to be pretty, people. Things are going to get very, very messy in the short term, right? So anyway, just keep an eye out for the follow-up on this video, right? This is Sir P. Mega, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.